Let us now explore these special triangles. Here are five brilliant questions based on trigonometry foundation in the right angle triangle. I hope their solutions will give you a good start in this particular topic. So let's begin the journey of trigonometry with the help of this particular video. Thank you. I am Anil Kumar. Welcome to my YouTube channel and the website Global Math Institute. In this video, we'll discuss special angle triangle and the basic concepts of trigonometry. Let me also welcome all my students who are preparing for GAUS, Waterloo exam, or a competition for grades 7 and 8 students. Trigonometry is a very important topic for you. Since it is not covered in the school level, it will be good for you to know exactly what we are doing in this video. Follow our playlist to prepare and get better for appearing in this particular test. I am Anil Kumar. Welcome to my YouTube channel and the website Global Math Institute. We have taken a very important topic, which is trigonometry, and we are considering special angle triangles in this particular video. Let me also welcome all my students preparing for GAUS, Waterloo exam for middle school students, grades 7 and 8. I hope this video helps you. You can also join my classes by sending an email on the address given. So we'll talk about special angle triangles and take up five very important questions based on the concept. You can see the questions here. Here's question number 1 and then question number 2, 3, 4 and 5. So they also include the word problem and to work with triangles, more than one triangle at a time. So that will give you the confidence and a good start. Well, the question number 1 here is, determine exact value of the following. Sine 60 times tan 30 minus cos 30 degrees, cos square 45 or sine square 45 minus 1, cos square 30 degrees plus sine square 30 degrees. I also provided the special triangles right here so that, you know, initially, it is a good practice to remember them. Once you see them a couple of times, you will get an idea of what the values could be. So here is your 30, 60, 90 triangle whose sides are 1, square root 3 and 2. And then we have 45, 45, 90 whose sides are 1, 1, square root 2. So let's begin by writing the values for sine 60 times tan 30 minus cos 30. You can also do the needful and get the right result. Well, sine 60. So if you look from the 60 degrees, the opposite side here is square root 3 and the hypotenuse is 2. And therefore, sine 60 can be written as square root 3 over 2, correct? So you remember, sine is the ratio of opposite over hypotenuse. Cosine is the ratio of adjacent over hypotenuse. And tan is the ratio of opposite over adjacent side. So we got the value of sine 60, now tan 30. If you look from 30 degrees angle, tan is opposite over adjacent. It is 1 over square root 3, right? So let me write down 1 over square root 3 here. Minus cos of 30 degrees. Cos is adjacent over hypotenuse, which is square root 3 over 2. So we have square root 3 over 2 for cos 30 degrees. Perfect. So we have all these. You can now simplify and write down the result. Well, as you can see, the 30 square root 3 square root 3 cancel, right? And so we get half minus square root 3 over 2. So we can rewrite this as equal to half minus square root 3 over 2. Perfect, right? So, or you can just take common denominator of 2 and write 1 minus square root 3 in the numerator. So that is how you're going to get the first value. The second one is very interesting. Cos square 45 over sine square 45 minus 1. Well, for 45 degrees, sine and cosine have exactly the same value, correct? Opposite side and adjacent, both are 1, right? So you know what result you should be expecting. Well, anyway, let's write down the values. Cos 45 is 1 over square root 2 and square of that, right? So let me rewrite this as 1 over square root 2 and then square this, right? Over sine, same value, right? 1 over square root 2 whole square minus 1, and that definitely is 1 minus 1, which indeed is 0. Perfect. So that is how we get this value. Now we have cos square 30 degrees plus sine square 30 degrees. If you look from 30 degrees, the value of cosine is square root 3 over 2. So we'll write square root 3 over 2 whole square, right? That is cos square 30 degrees plus sine square 30 degrees, opposite over hypotenuse. We get 1 over 2 whole square. And clearly, when I rewrite this, opening the squares, we get 3 over 4 plus what? Plus 1 over 4, right? So we get 3 over 4 and plus 3 over 4 plus 1 over 4, and that indeed is 4 over 4, which is just 1. Well, remember, cos square theta plus sine square theta is always 1. So that's an identity, right? So let's rewrite and remember the identity, which is cos square theta plus sine square theta is 1. And therefore, we did expect 1 as our answer. The whole idea here is to get familiar with your special triangles and see how you can read the values, substitute and evaluate the expressions. Perfect. So I hope that part is absolutely taken care of. Let's move on to question number 2. And here, the idea here is that we'll now look into the values of trigonometric expressions. The question here is, which of the following are equal to cos of 30 degrees? Well, let's write down what is the value of cos of 30 degrees, right? So cos of 30 degrees is square root 3 over 2, right? Perfect. Now, sine of 60 degrees, if you look from here, sine opposite side is square root 3, and that is also equal to square root 3 over 2. Sine of 30 degrees, however, is just half, right? And if I do 1 minus sine square 30 degrees, well, let me figure this out. Within the square root, 1 minus square of 1 over 2 will be 1 over 4, right? So that gives me what? Well, that does give me square root 3 over 2 when I simplify. Makes sense, right? The last one here, the option sine 30 degrees. Sine 30 degrees is half, right? Half divided by tan of 30 degrees. Well, tan of 30 degrees, 1 over square root 2. So I can write 1 over square root 3, right? So 1 over square root 3 for tan, and that also gives me square root 3 over 2. So what you notice here is that cos of 30 degrees, which is square root 3 over 2, is indeed equal to sine of 60 degrees, is also equal to 1 minus sine square 30 degrees square root, and is also equal to tan 30, sine 30 divided by tan 30. You see that? Well, these are all the identities, right? This is called co-function identity. Right? So you can join my classes and learn more. How could we answer these questions very easily just by looking at them? Well, and this has been derived from trigonometric identity, which is Pythagorean trig identity, right? So this is your Pythagorean trig identity. Perfect. And the last one here is the quotient identity. You should remember that tan theta is indeed equals to sine theta over cos theta. So when you cross multiply and rearrange, you get cos theta as a ratio of sine and tangent, right? So you see that. So with this example, we not only evaluate the values and compare them, we are also learning different identities, which will be useful as we move along, right? I hope that makes sense, right? Okay, let's move on and now look into the different aspect. And this time, We'll find the angles, okay? Earlier, we were only evaluating the expressions. Now, let's find the angles. Question number 3 here is, determine angle theta if theta is between 0 to 90 degrees, right? So, in a right angle triangle, all other angles are less than 90 degrees, ref. Sine theta equals to square root 2 over 2. Well, sine theta equals to square root 2 over 2, we know the angle has to be 45 degrees, right? So, we know theta is equals to 45 degrees from the very special triangle, correct? So, when you look at this special triangle, right, which is 1, 1 square root 2, if I multiply each side by square root 2, what do I get? Well, I get square root 2 over 2. You see that, right? So you could see 45, 90 degrees as this also. The next one here is 2 cos theta minus 1 equals to 0. We need to find the angle theta. Well, let's rearrange. And when we rearrange, what do we get? Well, we get 2 cos theta equals to 1. And that means that cos theta should be equal to half, right? So cos theta equals to half. When is cos theta equals to half? When the adjacent side is 1 and hypotenuse is 2, and that happens when theta is equal to 60 degrees, right? So 60 degrees is the answer for part B. Makes sense, right? So I hope you are getting it, right? Feel free to join my classes by sending an email, right? And excel and learn more. Perfect. The last one here is square root 3 tan theta equals to 1. So when you rearrange, what do you get? Well, clearly, when you rearrange, we get tan theta equals to 1 over square root 3. And when we have 1 over square root 3, we are looking from 30 degrees angle, the opposite side being 1, adjacent being square root 3. And therefore, we can say that theta is equal to 30 degrees. Makes sense. So in this part of the video, we have understood how do we find the angle using the special triangles, correct? Not the calculator. Perfect. Now, in many exams and competitions, you are not allowed the calculator, and these special triangles help you to find the result, right? And therefore, the mastery in this particular area is kind of a must. Perfect. So now, let's move on to the next question, which is question number 4 for us. It's a word problem based on height and distance. The question here is, 40 feet ladder forms an angle of 60 degrees with the wall. Can it reach the height of 35 feet on the wall? Explain. Take value of square root 3 as 1.73. So it's a good idea to make a diagram, right? So let us say that we have an even ground, right? Let's say this is the ground and we have this wall here, right? Okay. And 60 degrees, the ladder is making an angle with the wall, right? So that means here, the angle will be kind of like this, right? So the angle, 60 degrees with the wall, ladder makes, means this angle is 60 degrees. Do you see that? And the length is 40 feet, right? Now, we need to check if this height reached is 35 feet or not, right? That's what we are looking into. So definitely, it forms a right angle triangle, a special one, whose sides are 30, 60, 90. So that should help you to find the height, maximum height, which this ladder will reach while making an angle of 60 degrees with the wall. Right? So the angle made with the wall is right there, you can see. Well, the diagram is not to the scale, but it does give you an idea, right? Perfect, perfect. So when you want to relate, we are actually looking at the side, which is adjacent, and the hypotenuse, correct? So we can use the cosine ratio, right? So we have cos of 60 degrees is basically equal to the height over the length of the ladder, right? So that gives you the height as equals to 40 times cos of 60 degrees. Now, if you look at the special triangle, you know, cos of 60 is half, 1 over 2, right? So it is actually equals to 40 times half or just 20 feet, right? So clearly, the ladder cannot reach 35. It just goes up to 20 feet. Well, if you want to use similar triangles concept, in that case also, you can see hypotenuse and the adjacent side, they are related. They are half of one another, right? So therefore, you could have just got the answer very fast, no problems, correct? So that is how we can actually answer this particular question. Perfect. Now, let's look into the last question. It is, again, a word problem where we have two different triangles involved. This is not to the scale, so remember that part. Perfect. The question here is, determine exact area of the triangle if tan alpha, this is the angle alpha, is equal to 1, and CD is perpendicular to AB, so this is perpendicular to AB. So let me just make it like this. So it's perpendicular to AB. You need to find this particular triangle area. We are also given that the angle here, which is DCB, is 60 degrees, right? So angle DCB is equal to 60 degrees, right? So I'd like you to now pause the video, answer the question, and then look into my suggestions. Well, just a reminder, in case you want to learn directly from me, you can always send an email on the address given. It's good time to prepare for competitions and be ahead of the competition. Perfect. Now, what is the area of a triangle? Well, the area of a triangle is basically equal to half of base times height, right? So in this case, the base basically is A to B, right? And the height is C to D. So that is the area which we need to calculate. We know CD, right? So let me write down that we know CD, which is equal to 8. We need to find A to B. Well, we are given that tan alpha is 1, right? We're given tan alpha is 1. That sounds good. Tan alpha equals to 1. It really means that the ratio of CD and AD is 1, right? So we can write this as CD over AD, right? As you know, sine is opposite over hypotenuse. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. Tan is opposite over adjacent. So tan is 1, right? So opposite is this and adjacent is that. Their ratio is 1 means they are equal. That means AD is, say, 8, right? So from here, I know that AD is equal to CD, right? And that is equal to 8 units. So we know AD is 8. Perfect. And now, let's try to calculate what should be the value of D to B. Now, D to B is a side which is opposite to 60 degrees. And we are given a side which is 8 and which is adjacent. So we are looking at opposite and adjacent once again from 60 degrees. That means we have to again look into which ratio? Again, we have to look into tangent ratio, correct? So what is tan 60? So we have tan 60 degrees as equal to opposite side DB, right? I've changed the ink, right? Less space here, over DC. So tan of 60 using this particular triangle is basically square root 3. So we can use square root 3 over 1. So we have square root 3 here, right? And we need to find what B to D is. So I'll just cross multiply with DC, right? And I get B to D or DB, right? So DC is given to us as 8. So it is 8 square root 3, right? So 8 square root 3 is BD for us. Perfect. So we know this side is 8 square root 3. So now we know the base, which is sum of 8 and 8 square root 3. And we know the height, which is 8. And so we can find the area, which is half of AB is 8 plus 8 square root 3. And CD is 8 for us, right? So that is what it is. So we can simplify this multiplying by 4, right? So 4 times 8 plus 8 square root 3, right? Gives us the area, which is 32 plus 32 square root 3, right? So that becomes the exact value. So let me write down here in red the area, which is 32 plus 32 square root 3 units square, right? So units are centimeter, So we'll write this as centimeter square. Does it make sense to you, right? So that is the exact value. In case you want to convert that, then you can always multiply, right, with square root 3, and then we'll do 32 times square root 3. And what you get here is around 87.4, right? So this is around 87.4 centimeter square, okay? So that is how we can actually calculate the area of the given triangle. Extremely important question. I hope with this you have understood how we could solve questions related to special triangles, right? So the last one here involved more than two triangles, and we see how do we figure out the sides of a triangle and then find the area. Hope it all makes sense. Feel free to write a comment, share your views. If you like and subscribe to my videos, it'd be great. Thanks for your time and all the best.